Hold on to your wallets. A whole new water utility is in the works, and it could cost Oahu residents, businesses, and even the state and federal government dearly. Gina Mangieri is always investigating and joins us now with more. Gina?
Well, it's called the Storm Water Utility, and it aims to raise as much as $100 million a year. It could go in for city council sign-up as soon as this summer, and the city says it is essential for environmental improvements. Now, among the details being worked out, how much it will cost each ratepayer, and whether it will be on your property tax bill or on a new invoice.
Honolulu residents and businesses have grown used to paying their electric, sewer, and water bills, but get ready to dig even deeper. A new storm water utility is forming as we speak.
In order for us to continue to have the water quality that people really aspire to visit and play in, we have to make sure that we have all the necessary pieces in place, not only enforcement, not only regulation, but devices or measures that actually decrease or eliminate the pollutants that could jeopardize the quality of our nearshore waters.
Here's how it would work. The county would charge either through a property tax hike or through a monthly rate based on property types and tiers. They're trying to as much as double what gets spent on stormwater operations and capital. And the preliminary math on that pencils out to the equivalent of a 16% property tax hike on the residential rate, or $35 a month, $420 a year per homeowner.
Many local families, many local businesses are struggling, and some of these monthly costs could be astronomical. How much more blood can you get from the stone when you put new taxes and fees on people?
Right, so we understand that, we're sensitive to that. So one of the things that we're really stressing is to find ways so that people, property owners actually, have the means to control what their bill looks like.
The program may incorporate credits for remodeling areas that are impervious now, designed to push storm water into the street or into the storm drains.
If we give people the option of either taking away some pavement, diverting roof gutters into gardens, using rain barrels to capture some of that storm water, those are things that may reduce the bill.
How much that would cut monthly remains to be seen. Apartment buildings could have to pay more than $13,000 a year. Hotels, even more than that. Federal or state facilities, right now exempt from property tax, could pay six figures annually. And watch out, Honolulu Airport, the draft shows a $300,000 a month bill for that, more than $4 million a year.
Could they really take advantage of any of these offsetting credits?
Sure, and that's one of the things that we're encouraging, because we do recognize that not only residents but also businesses have impacts that they want to try to avoid as well. And so actually, if you look at some of the newer developments, some of the high rises in Kaka'ako, they actually have cisterns that are designed to capture stormwater now. And these are all things that we want people to take full advantage of.
The city's Department of Facility Maintenance is taking the lead on public presentations that kicked off last week. There are 14 more yet to come. The city says they're not reinventing the wheel.
We're not the first. There's about 2,000 of them already in place in North America.
They say the proposed rates would be around what folks in Washington State pay. Even without the utility, about $46 million a year comes from property taxes to cover existing stormwater operations.
How are we all paying for it right now?
Well, right now, property taxes handles a good deal of it. One of the concerns and one of the issues that we have with the property tax revenue stream is that there are a number of competing priorities. So if people want better fire protection or more police protection, that means that other agencies will get less money than they typically would have otherwise.
While this is a whole different category from drinking water and sewer fees you pay for separately, the city says focusing on stormwater handling is needed to keep those systems adequate for the future, too.
As we continue to develop on this island, as more people live here, the drawdown of our aquifer, our drinking water supply, is going to get greater and greater. And the more we develop for more homes for people to live in, we're going to be generally shedding more water off into the storm drain system. And so we're trying to balance this off so that we maximize the amount of drinking water available for everybody and also protect our environmental assets that we have, the clean water that we all enjoy.
Now, there's a link on our website with the public meeting schedule, which runs through February and March. Public comments are also being taken online. The final pitch has to go before the city council, and that could start this summer. We will continue to follow up. Gina Mangieri, KHON2 News, always investigating.